Hey guys, this is the final week of the 2017 CrossFit Games Open. 17.5 will be announced Thursday evening at around 8 p.m. We will have that announcement live at the gym, and as soon as two of CrossFit's top athletes finish attacking 17.5, we are going to put Coach John Junkin up against Zach. They're going to go head-to-head and knock out whatever the workout is. Now, it hasn't been announced yet, so we don't know, but I have a feeling there will be dumbbell thrusters. Every year, the Open has had thrusters, and they've always been in the final week. Never been with dumbbells before, but with a new implement, the dumbbell, they get much more difficult. So, to help you guys prepare for what might come out on Thursday, we are starting the week off with some dumbbell thrusters. Monday is going to be a big cycle of Tabatas. You're going to do four individual Tabatas with 1 minute of rest in between them. Each Tabata is 20 seconds of work followed by 10 seconds of rest for 8 cycles. Your first Tabata is going to be on box overs. Then you're going to go on to GHD sit-ups. Next is dumbbell thrusters, and then it finishes off with double unders. You're trying to stay consistent with each round of 20 seconds working that you commit to. We're taking the lowest score on these Tabatas, which means that if I start off with 14 box overs and I hold that for most of the rounds, then my last two rounds only have 6 reps, then my score is 6. So we're trying to find that number that you can stay consistent with. Now don't start slow and easy, start hard but hold. Tuesday, we've got a 4-round workout. You're going to be doing 20 medicine ball cleans, 20 hand release push-ups, and then 20 knees to elbows. Good bit of work here. Short breaks, try to keep yourself moving on those med ball cleans. They really do burn up the legs because there's 2 squats in each rep. Knees to elbows, if you need to scale those, they scale just like toes to bars. After you finish that workout, you will immediately go into a 10-minute window to build up to and establish a 2-rep max touch and go power clean. Everybody's gonna finish this at a different time because it depends on when you finish the first piece. 4 rounds of 20-20-20 followed immediately by that 10-minute window. Wednesday, we're working some strength. We're gonna superset behind the neck presses and L hands. Now, behind the neck presses are not a movement that we've done a lot of, but you will see it coming forward. We need to build strength in that position. Behind the head, we have a very interesting mechanic with our shoulder, and it causes us to need a lot of range of motion. A good bit of flexibility through the shoulder and the rib cage, as well as a lot of motor control. And building that through a slow and steady press is a good way to get more comfortable catching bars on your back. Don't be afraid to start light. This is going to be tricky at first. By the end of this, we're going to build up to a 3-rep max for the movement. After that, you've got a longer workout. I put a 20-minute cap on it. It's rowing and overhead squats. Now, the row and overhead squats both start off at pretty big volume, and they descend together. But as they descend, the overhead squat weight increases. The last round and the last movement you're gonna do is 5 overhead squats, and they should be very, very heavy for you. So your scaling needs to reflect that. On Thursday, we are hitting a hero workout. Jennifer is a 26-minute AMRAP of 10 pull-ups, 15 kettlebell swings, at our standard weights, 53 for guys and 35 for gals, and then 20 box hops, 24-inch for guys and 20-inch for gals. Now this workout, you're probably gonna wanna get out some chips to help you count. You wanna try to find a fluid action going on your pull-ups, get through that set pretty quickly, maybe with 1 break in it. Then on your kettlebell swings, where it's kind of the same game plan, you can take a rest, but you want to keep it small, and then you need to treat the box hops like burpees. You just find a rhythm, doesn't need to be fast, but you need to keep moving. There's not really any rest in those box hops. Friday, we are going to be prepping for 17.5. Not sure what it is yet, so I can't tell you what we're going to be doing. There will be some rowing intervals at the end of that prep session, but we are going to focus on mobility and movement to help you guys improve your potential for workout 17.5, the final workout in this year's Open. We'll be attacking that workout Saturday morning, so please come on in, bring friends, bring family, let's get together and cheer each other on and push each other through this last piece of the 2017 CrossFit Games Open. I'll see you guys this week.